evening and welcome to Planning Highways Committee, City Town Council, on the 23rd of February. There's a couple of announcements, safety announcements. We're not expecting a fire drill tonight. If the bell does go off, the fire alarm does go off, it's not continuing again. Two ways of getting out. We've got the door behind us, down the steps, be careful, it can be quite slippery. And then the way you came in, down the stairs and out the way without the front. If you can't manage the stairs, it's call me great by the lift, and hopefully you get rescued. You're not allowed to use the lift. Okay. I think that's it for the stairs. I think that's basically it, isn't it, really? So anything else? No. Okay, right, so, agenda item number one, for absence.
Apologies from Councillor McLean, Councillor Worcester and Councillor Walraven.
Agenda item two, disclosure of interests, a spill of any disclosure by members of any disclosure of pecuniary interests and interests other than pecuniary, as defined under the Seaford Town Council Code of Conduct and Localism Act 2011 in relation to matters on the agenda. Councillor Borman?
Yeah, so I'm looking to the action of Seaford LW0786CN over pecuniary interest in that, so I want to be involved in the debate.
Thank you, Councillor. Just myself, again, on the same item there, as an employee of this Kenny Council, I'll do the question, I won't be voting in any way, I'll be consistent to what happened in the last time, so I'll be consistent, I won't be doing any views forward again, so I basically abstain, essentially. Right, so Councillor?
Craigville
Hill, the
LW0786, yeah, non-pecuniary.
Right, yeah.
Was that the same with Councillor Borman?
I missed
what you said, I'm sorry.
I used the promises for my...
Yours is pecuniary?
Yeah.
I can point of order at that.
Go on,
I understand that if you have got a pecuniary interest in the property that you're not allowed to speak in the discussions.
You won't speak, I understood that from what you said that you won't speak all those.
Correct, yeah.
My own ones are concerned employee of this as a Kenny Council, even though I've got no influence in any decision really. Be consistent on this. I haven't voted in it. I have been in when it's been discussed, but I haven't actually done any. I haven't voted for, or against, or abstained. A lot of things.
Yes, yeah. I did ask for clarification on this, and I was told that if you've got a pecuniary interest, then you couldn't talk. But if you've got a non-pecuniary interest, you can.
And not vote, of course.
Sure.
Councillor Borman,
can we move that forward to the first meeting point of the meeting, Chair?
Absolutely. We'll just keep item three first, just in case, and then we'll move that. It'll be the first one when we get to item four. So.
I'll just point out, Chair, that the business people in the building this evening and actually dropped down in orders for them in order to answer the questions of councillors due to the nature of it last time with the misunderstanding of what was going on.
Absolutely, Councillor Paul. We'll just do item three, then when we get to four, we'll jump straight into that and we'll suspend standing orders at that time. And it's almost like a mini public question time, a little bit for a while. Then when we do the discussion out here, we will obviously go back to standing orders, or we'll have a little bit of listening and a couple of questions or so. Right, so item three first, though.
Are there any other interests, Mr. Chairman?
Any other interests?
Whether we finished that or not.
Everyone's happy. Sorry.
It's okay.
That's cool. Agenda item three, and public participation in accordance with Standing Order 3 and Standing Town Council policy members of the public will be entitled to speak of general issues concerning this committee on non-planning application matters at this point. People wishing to speak of planning applications may do so immediately before each planning application. So, do you want to talk about anything general? Fine, that's a no. Go on, Councillor.
Sorry, it's a general one, so I thought I'd pop it in at the beginning.
That's more for the public, isn't it?
Yes, I know, but it's a general one. So
go on, Councillor.
I just like it recorded, really, that going through today's agenda, there are actually five submissions that have not included combined plans, which we were promised from Lewis District Council, which makes, looking at these much, much more arduous and quite time consuming. So if we could complain about that, please.
Okay.
And there was also one that was virtually illegible as well. So, yeah.
Okay. When our planning officer replies back to Lewis District and elsewhere after this meeting, I I'll just mention, in the body of the email, to mention that.
Do you want it minuted, or are you happy for me just to pass it on when I send the decisions back to them tomorrow morning?
Yes, that's fine.
Okay, could
we have it mentioned, please?
Right.
Because
okay.
The issue regarding the one where we couldn't read the plans, which is LW17-0046, it was a terrible submission, and I can't vote on that because I didn't understand what the hell they were trying to do. And I spent half an hour trying to sort it out, and I just don't think that's good enough. And we've raised these issues before. And I think we just need to reinforce it. Don't mind.
So what number was that again?
That was number 170046.
Problems with the diagram.
The first one for 3rd of February.
We can perhaps add that comment to whatever comments you make on that application, and I'll highlight them when I go back to Lewis tomorrow morning with the decision.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so planning applications, agenda item number 4, planning applications. So we'll jump right down to the bottom of page 2. So it's reconsultation Seaford LW/0786/CM, Unit 3, Clover Hill Industrial Estate. And so this has now come back to us. 3 weeks ago, we did have a discussion here. I think. Sometimes with these very big applications, relatively speaking, we don't always get all the information prior to it, when it either goes to Lewis District or Lewis City County Council for the actual decision when it goes to them. So I think even in the last few weeks, we've had much more information come through, and it's a bit more clearer now what's going on. And we've also got the developer here as well, and the two residents who live close by in the it's Cayman Avenue, isn't it?
Cayman Avenue.
So I don't know if we suspended standing orders now anyway at this stage. We suspended it, so this is more of a, so if you want to make some sort of presentation, I don't know what you've got in mind, and introduce yourselves please as well.
My name's Mr Green, I'm a partner in that business. Our suggestions are we've got a problem with the height, so I'm led to believe. And as we put forward, we want to take off a metre and a half to 2 metres off the floor, so the height stays the same. So there's no alteration in the height line.
So is that something you're going to be doing, or is that where on the documentation at the moment, when you sort of work it out, it seems as though it's like 2.5 metres higher. That's how I read it.
Is that the word? No, that's...
Unless there's new things coming along and we haven't...
No, in the previous application, there was some drawings done or some sort of plans to saying we were going to take... Because the previous application got rejected on the height.
Right.
So we reduced the height significantly, and we put forward we were taking off the ground level. Just purely so you can get clearance for the highest vehicle to tip. And that's where we're at again now. We're just, we'll take it down and not go up. It's at an extortionate expense to us.
I mean, how I read it at the moment, it's not. We have broken standing orders. If you want to chat with council.
Well, I just wanted to know whether that is my clarity in the plans, because
I've looked through and looked through, and there seems an awful lot of text and not a lot of measurements that are off. Can I have you finish your full presentation, or do you want to come back? No, there's a slight bit of confusion in the drawings as well, because the first shed, the first two sheds are lower than the back shed, and basically the whole shed is coming up to the original ridge height, which is there now. So it's all coming up. I think there was a little bit of confusion that was going to stay the same, which it isn't. It's all going to come up as one big shed.
Can I use the relevant bit from there?
Do you want to come back then?
There's just one relevant paragraph in the design and access statement on pages 21 and 22 that I've managed to extract, which says, in relation to the appearance and scale of the building, the paragraph says, this is from the agents for the applicant, as shown in the submitted drawings,
it has been proposed to sink the new building into the ground by 1.5 metres, as Mr Green has explained, in comparison to the existing ground level. The height of the proposed building is 10.01 metres above existing ground level, with eaves at 8.03 metres. The current building has a maximum height of 7.475 metres. The proposed increase in height is to facilitate safe full operation of tipper trucks and railroad trucks within the confines of the building, removing the risk of damaging the building structure. So that makes it clear, and I've clarified it in discussions with the agent's representative who drew up the plans, that the height of the new building will be 2.5 metres higher than the existing building. But members obviously want to hear from both sides. The issues really to balance out when you're making your comments is, on the one hand, the fact that the building will be 2.5 metres higher. On the other hand, as far as amenity is concerned, there will be an improvement in the appearance of the building. And also the fact that Mr Green has explained that the idea is to, if you like, smooth out the operations on site by having a purpose-built building as opposed to the current building, which is not really suitable for purpose, and therefore the idea being to control noise, odours and the general nuisances that might arise in a skip business. So you've got, on the one hand, the fact that it is 2.5 metres higher and the impact on residents around there, as we heard in the complaints or the objections at the last meeting. But on the other hand, helping, if you like, an established local business by allowing it to improve the standard of its operations. But so, as I say, it's a question of balancing that against the residential amenity issues, which is not an easy matter, but it has to be done.
Before we move on to that, can we just clarify the site business, please? Because at the moment, the way I understand it is that the height will be the whole building will be 2.5 metres higher than it is now. But 1.5 metres of that is going to be sunk down.
It's going from 7.475 metres to 11.51 metres. But if it's going lower, 1.5, and if you take 1.5 off the difference, you then get 2.5.
That's
2.5 metres higher. That's how I read it.
The elevation gives us that 2.5 metres.
The roof line is staying the same.
But the actual roof line is still staying the same. But it's sort of it's.
Well, that's not the way it's just read, is it?
No, it's clear as mud.
The current building is 7.5 metres.
That's the actual measurement
from ground to
at the highest point
from ground to ridge. From ground to ridge.
But if it's levelled out, then
the new building will be 11.5 metres high, but 1.5 will be set into the ground, so it'll be 10 metres high. With eaves at 8 metres, so it'll be 2.5 metres higher than it is.
Okay. So it will be 2.5 metres higher.
But it will be visually an improvement in what's there.
You've got to look at it as if you look out your window, look at a garden shed that's falling to pieces, you'd rather look at a new one than one that's looking nice or any garden.
That's debatable.
Did you want to talk a bit more about this?
What we've got to remember in this particular, it is an industrial estate which we're bringing up to a better standard than anything
with the times.
Yeah, we're bringing it up to the modern ages. Is that everything's going to be contained inside? We're actually, you know, in negotiations at the moment to take the lorries and rehouse them at another yard down in New Haven, which, you know, takes all that movement away. So, it is the building for the job.
Do you Do you want to come and say your side? I just want to know if you want to say, or yours come back. You have to spend this percent in August. So would you like to just introduce yourself quickly? And,
yes, my name is Lynn Lawson. This is my mother, Madge Murdoch, who lives at 17 Cannon Avenue, which is the property nearest to the site. She's been there for 60 years, and that's where I've grown up, so I obviously know it very well. My mother's house and bungalow, my bungalow and garden are very close to the building. I did send some photographs which do illustrate. There's just the narrow road that goes from the original cemetery to the new part of the cemetery. That's all that separates my mum's garden from the site. The new building, as we've just established, is going to be 2.5 metres taller. So we'll be quite imposing in the garden, and it's a larger footprint as well, so it will extend presumably further down. And I think looking at the diagrams, I'm not very technical, but the current building is the highest point slopes down more steeply than the new plan. So the new plan, there'll be a higher, it looks to me, it looks to us as if there'll be a higher proportion of the building at the higher height, the tall height. We also have concerns about the noise levels. It's going to be a bigger building. There's nothing really in the plans about any soundproofing. Someone last time thought there might be soundproofing, but there's nothing in the plans about it. At the moment, you can hear the machinery rumbling in the building. So in a bigger building with more vehicles going in, that's going to be louder as well, presumably. But I don't really feel it's addressed in these plans. And I think it comes over in the plans that the business is going to expand. They want to go from 13 staff to 20. So that implies there will be more activity in the site, more activity in the building, more noise. So our objections are twofold, really. Firstly, the size and scale of the building, which will be very imposing in my mother's garden, and also the potential increase in noise levels, which is acknowledged in the plan. It does say there will be potential, I forget how it's phrased, but there will be an increase in something to do with the tranquility. So I think, you know, we're all in favour of recycling and can see why the business wants to expand. But you say it's an industrial estate. It's an industrial estate looking from one side, but when you come the other side, you've got the cemetery and residential properties where there are no industrial buildings. And a chapel of rest in the cemetery, yeah.
We're actually saying it's not industrial estate because it's actually very near industrial estate.
And B, the building will have one entry, so the noise won't be coming out of different parts of the building. Now it's got an entry here, it's got a side door there, and the building is purpose built for the job, so it will bounce around. The acoustics will make it naturally bounce out. The door will be obviously on the Cradle Hill side, so any noise would go out that way anyway.
Towards Parkers.
I know you've got pecuniary interests, I don't know what you want to do.
I was just going to say, this table's a drop, so this doesn't, I could actually just say.
When we get the formal discussion, then obviously you can't do anything. No, depending on what you want to say at this stage.
What I was just going to say is that it's a transfer station, there's waste stored in there. Which actually acts as a sound barrier, so you're storing waste there, it's not going to be as noisy, because mostly it's a storage being to be transferred, yeah, so it's, you know, it actually doesn't absorb noise.
I'm sorry, but is this gentleman really allowed to
speak? Yeah, because it's not standing orders.
No, standing orders are regarded.
It's just an opinion, it's not actually a...
No, standing orders, Chairman, were dropped to allow
a little bit of two-way
free discussion, and to bring it forward in the agenda, but it doesn't affect the fact that the declaration of the interest means they should not speak on verbal.
It's just purely the procedure
general procedure, bringing it forward and allowing a freer discussion between the people.
Oh, I should leave them at this point, Chair, until we finish.
If you
that.
Find that easier, Councillor,
yes, then, fine.
Then, that's fine, no problem with that. Go on, Councillor.
Just a couple of points, really. It is an industrial estate, but I think we've got to bear in mind that it does abut these other properties, including a cemetery, you know, a chapel of rest, and obviously residential properties. And I think it's also worth mentioning that it you know, we have had other objections, and Mrs. Lawson's here tonight, but there are plenty of other people that have brought up other issues, one of which is the increase in traffic going to the site and the impact on the roads leading to the Cradle Hill estate, you know, especially the rat run that's used along Corrie Lane and even up of Belgrade Road and Belgrade Road. So I think we shouldn't neglect the fact that it's not just one resident who's abutting it, there are lots of other concerns as well about the increase. And I would say that obviously this is a well-needed business and something that we should encourage, but perhaps not at that particular site. You know, it's outgrown, I would say, that particular site.
I mean, I wouldn't mind asking a question if I'm allowed to. Yeah. I mean, does it have to be that size you've designed? I mean, that's just...
Well, that was maximising the footprint there.
Right, that's the way you've gone.
That is how, you know, to maximise it. On the issue of the alleged rat run, I've had a meeting with the highways, and if anyone comes to our office, there is a note on the desk telling our drivers not to use them particular roads. And one of my suggestions was to the highways man who come down was to put a 7.5-ton restriction on it, because at the moment it's not illegal to go down.
Buses go down there,
there's everyone uses it from the industrial estate. It's not just us, it's everyone who uses it. And my suggestion to the highways was put a 7.5-ton restriction on it, then it becomes illegal. But we've told all our drivers to not to use that.
Councillor Hodgson.
Well, I've had a meeting with East Sussex County Council about Upper Belgrade Road, as far as weight limits.
That's concerned.
They said there's a benchmark to reach, and it hasn't reached the benchmark with the amount of traffic that uses it. So they will not put a weight limit on it.
At this stage.
But we, in our wisdom, have told our drivers not to use them.
I was going to remark on that. I've seen the notices and all, and I've actually been. I live in the road, so I know exactly what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. And there's more of Mr. Green's trucks come past my house now than there used to be. And I've also had reports from Corrie Lane, Bale Road, they no longer see the trucks coming past.
I think we've got to acknowledge that this is an expanding business, which is a good thing in general, but I just question whether it's in the right place or a larger.
That's one reason why I asked the question. Does it have to be that size? I just put it out there, really. It doesn't have to be that. If it's to maximise the site you've got, the plot, but I can see why you answered like that. But I just wondered how you worked it all out. Is there going to be any staff in Newhaven? You know, your place you had down in Newhaven?
We're looking at the.
But does that include staff back there?
We're going to move the transport that's parked there overnight. We're going to move that to Newhaven. We're going to remove the office there. So it will be just there, just to tip, instead of using it as an office,
everything.
Instead of, as out the side as the repairs, we're going to move all that side of the operation away from there.
Okay.
Well,
I'll be
Right, do you want to say a bit more? You're welcome to before we bring it back into sort of.
Another thing I'd quite like to query in the report is that this idea of the everything goes on inside the closed building, and it says there's a roller shutter door that's going to open every time a truck comes. So and then are you really intending to say, right, all the work stops when the roller shutter door is up. I mean, it says that there were 350 something lorry movements in a week, wasn't it? I think in here somewhere. And there's going to be more if it's expanding. So I mean, I'm not quite sure how the roller shutter door with the noise is going to work, really, because it's not going to contain the noise in the building if it keeps having to open to let the trucks in, is it?
Well, you put some sort of, you know, the curtains they use, the, if you don't open the chair, you put the curtains, the plastic drapes.
I know, that's what you mean. Yeah.
And that bounces them back. They dry through and they come back. It goes back to, it's something that's built to the job and not what we've got now, which is going to be there, you know, it is there as we stand. We can only improve.
What would happen if you didn't do the work on it now? I mean, how long has the building got left? And I think you said on one of the, how long we got left on the building, would you say? If you did nothing?
Well, 10 years.
Yeah, right.
10 years. But we'd have to repair the building and carry on the work.
Right.
You know, we'd do a plan that building, that's where we are, and we'd have to repair the existing building.
Councillor Fong.
Thank you, Chair. When I first looked at this, I was looking at it from the point of view of the business and trying to do everything I could to think, yes, we've got to accommodate this business, we need business in Seaford, etc. But I can't help but feel from the discussion that the business has been so successful, it's outgrown the facility.
Mm-hmm.
And when that happens generally in business, if you can't reasonably accommodate and adapt to the facility you have, then you have to find alternative accommodation. And I wonder whether you've looked at that option, particularly comparing the prices, the cost of what you're planning, if you're going to take out 1.5 metres of concrete floor, as well as the alterations. I think that cost is quite significant. And I wonder whether it would actually be more cost effective to move to a different site.
No, because there's no, the licences, it's not just like
taking a
warehouse
just,
it's the licences and all the, everything that goes with it. It's, you know, it's not just moving trucks and offices, it's the licence, dealing with the agency.
Could I come back on that?
Yeah.
I think it's a very interesting discussion, this, but I still think we need to defer for further thought and consideration rather than come to a decision.
I mean, in a way, this is the second time it's come back. Well, we're not actually making the decision anyway. And that's how I see it. I think we've got to get something back. I don't know how you see it.
There's a danger in missing the deadline
for
the County Council's consideration of it. It's not certain to be considered at the March meeting, but it's possible. I was told March or April. If it's the March meeting, it'll be difficult to get the comments before the meeting is held.
Okay.
It's uncertain at the moment.
I do not believe, actually, I've looked at the plans and everything like that, and I do not believe that the building is going to be something between 10 and 15 foot higher than what it is now. Because that's what you're talking about.
No, definitely.
We
said
2.5 metres.
Yeah, well, that's 2.5 metres, not 10 feet.
Seven and a half feet, isn't it?
It's 8.8 inches. Yes.
That's still quite a bit higher.
Of course, it is.
My mum's garden. Never complained about the skip company at all before. You know, it's not been a problem. Although you can hear the noise. You know, she hasn't complained about it, but you know, when you stand in her garden, even in the lounge, and you look out of the window, you can see the building right there. And in the summer, the existing building, there's all buddleia and things that grow up alongside it, so actually in the summer it's very well screened. It's not at the moment because of, we're obviously not there in the winter, but how is that going to happen with a bigger building? And there's talk about planting trees that are going to take 15 years to grow, you know.
And that line grows very quickly, we just throw them up along the back. And the reason why there's no growth there at the moment is because people in the cemetery asked us if we would kindly cut the foliage down, because that is a wall of commemorance, and we was going to actually bolster the wall for them. We was going to actually pour concrete and get it right for them so that wall doesn't move. It's in danger of falling down at the moment.
I mean, it usually happens that you can't see it, you can see the building in the winter, but not in the summer, doesn't it?
Yeah, but it wouldn't grow in the summer because the cemetery have asked us to cut it back because the roots are growing under the wall at the moment and the wall of commemorance is actually falling.
Go on, Councillor Weber.
Okay, notwithstanding the issue with regard to the height, with regard to the increased activity, per se, could you give us an idea of how many more lorries will be using the facility than are at the moment?
Our business relies on the weather.
Yeah.
So when it's been raining, our business is cutting half at the moment. Mm.
On average. You must have done a business plan.
Yeah. 10 more movements, 10, 20, depending.
So do you average about 50 a day at the moment, would you say?
Yeah,
350.
It's going up by 20%,
to 10, 20%.
Yeah.
Okay.
Quite significant.
But who knows how the market goes?
Yeah.
You know, do we know how much the
market is
going?
You must have
if
a
we say,
of
if we average
issues,
it out
of
15%, say, in our calculation. But they're only guesstimates, aren't they?
Of course, yeah.
You know, who knows what we got round the corner in the market? It could all collapse, couldn't it?
As I said, there's so much documentation that's come with this, and it seems to me the vital things like the height, you know, we've had to delve and delve, and we still can't really agree. And also things like the lorry movements, which are crucial, really, to a decision on whether, you know, that is the right place for that business. I'm frustrated by that, really, that I've waded through loads and loads of things about how wonderful waste disposal is, but not got to the crux of what we've got to make,
make a decision. At the moment, I think, unless I'm corrected otherwise, I think we've got to make some sort of decision tonight, that's how I see it. Our opinion, we're not making the same decision, but we've got to make some sort of opinion tonight. I don't think we can defer it the second time. I think we've got to, when we go back to Stanley Hall, we'll have to do it formally again, and then you always just have to listen over there and just see where the debate goes, what we want to do. So
I think what we've got to decide, really,
it's a balance, isn't it?
Do we want an improved building there and purpose-built building, or do we want that building to carry on as it is and be patched up? Because that's what, you know, we're weighing up as a company. We don't want to upset anyone. We want to, you know, we've been over to the funeral parlour, you know, we've been around and asked, and they've been all, you know, in agreement. We've asked them to give them out their input, what they would like. You know, is something, and I'm at, if it's too harsh, you know, if we put a green colour on the back to soften it, is there some sort of climbing evergreen we can put on a trellis up there? I don't know, as I said, I'm not.
Yeah.
But the building is there, as we stand.
Mm.
And, you know, it's not the most pleasant building to look at.
No, I agree.
And if...
Ernie, would you like to say something? You don't normally
is there
say
a
something.
Noise level on the industrial site?
Sorry?
Is there a noise level on the industrial site?
Is
there bound to be more noise? Has that been looked into?
Well,
that
was my point, really. It hasn't really been addressed, I don't think, because there's
a limit up there for the noise.
I think the new building is, it's got to be an improvement in the sense of the soundproofing side of things anyway. I know
there's nothing in here about
soundproofing. Yeah, I don't know why it's not.
There's about three lines, which is sort of incomprehensible, really, because it's all about decibels and stuff, and doesn't really mean anything.
Which is what it's all about.
It doesn't say anything about soundproofing, and there's going to be more machines in the building, and you can hear them rumbling now. It's going to be a bigger building, surely, unless there's particular soundproofing, it's going to be louder, isn't it? Without the truck the increased truck movement as well, but you know, just the building itself, because the building is so close to my mum's garden, you know, there are sounds emitting from it now, and has any work been done on how loud it's going to be with more machinery? The whole point is to allow machinery a greater height so the machinery can operate more efficiently, and that it does say that there's going to be more activity in the building, yet that there's nothing here about how the sound is going to be monitored or deadened, or, you know.
The height's not so the machinery gets in, it's not bigger, it's so you can tip up easy. It's not about the machinery, the height.
You're not filling it up to the last.
Or the machines going up against the wall. The machinery will be the same.
Yeah.
And modern machinery will be quieter than the machines we're using now.
Because you are going to update all the...
Yeah.
All be updated.
Creeping belts, trommels.
Yeah.
It's just fine.
And our proposal is to run it, not diesel engines, we're going to run it off electric. So it's three phase, the electric runs and you ain't got the chugging of the... You're going to have the movements, you know, regardless whether we've got the building new or as is now, we still got that movement. But the noise with modern machinery meets, you know, better standards.
I can say for
in an average day at the moment, how long do the machines operate?
On and off.
On and off.
We drop them, you know, we don't leave them running.
They start at what, 8 in the morning? And
yeah, 8 till about 5.
Till about 5, and like for half an hour every hour, or an hour every hour? Or
yeah, it could be, time. You could run them for 2 hours, it depends.
And then nothing
what comes
for 2 or 3 hours?
Yeah, it could be. Yeah.
So with eight
some
more
days,
lorries
some
a day,
days it doesn't run at all.
With 8 more lorries a day, the operating time will be longer.
It depends on the rubbish.
On average.
Not necessarily.
Offset against that, you've got the electric machines rather than the mechanical machines, and therefore they will be a lot quieter.
And are these flaps going to be instead of a door? You're talking about flats, so the door's going to be open.
Yeah, you drop them down and they stop everything coming out.
Yeah, but not the noise.
Yeah, it stops the noise. It'll be facing out away from you, the graveyard and everything.
It's facing the other way too.
Yeah, but that's not going to make much difference.
Anyway, go on,
Captain. Just a little bit. Obviously, at the moment you keep the lorries outside and you start them up there in the mornings, because you're going to be moving to New Haven. We all know diesel vans, but they're noisy at the start up in the mornings and everything else. So you'll be obliterating that early morning noise, taking that away straight away.
Yeah.
So that's a plus in many ways, isn't it?
Yes.
I've been up there today, I've been in the furniture, I've been everywhere there. I'll take the roof, you'll try and bring it in somehow, bring it down a bit.
Just the lifting and picking up of the things, they'll be down in New Haven, so you won't be able to get all that
wires or anything,
so
it won't into that at all.
Mm.
What we have done there is, I don't know if everyone's aware of the site, there is a funeral parlour next door.
Yeah.
And we would actually, because it's a trying time for anyone who passes away, ask them, is there any colour, is there, you know, just to soften it.
Mm.
We don't want it to be a luminous and stand out. We want to soften it. And they've actually come round sometimes and said, I've got a funeral, private ceremony going on. Can you give us an hour to shut down? And we've turned all the machines off and just done it manually. So we are working.
They're interested in the colour.
Well, I think we're almost there. I think we'll reconvene standing orders. So if you. Nothing more to say. I think we've had quite a good discussion there.
I found a bit about the noise, but I don't know if it's worth. I can read it out if you like. It's very short.
Go on, it's just a paragraph. Go on.
It's it says the operational noise levels emitted from the site measured at something. It's technical. At the northern or western boundaries of the garden of 17 Camden Avenue, and in accordance with British standard, something shall be at least 5 decibels below the background LA 90 value. I mean, I don't really understand that, but it doesn't really say much, does it, about the noise?
Okay, for what it's worth, thank you. Right, so we'll standing orders is now started up again. So who would like to start? Anyone want to start? Well, we've got to try and come to some sort of decision tonight. We're not making a decision, some view on this anyway. Yeah. Who would like to start with? Well, we've had a lot of the debate anyway, haven't we? So we've already had it informally. So go on, Councillor Latham. Yeah.
As I said before, really, I came in feeling sort of very positive about it. Then I swung to being negative about it. And there was a discussion regarding the lorries being parked at New Haven and not starting up in the morning. In fact, I think the noise level overall will be lower rather than higher. If in some way you can measure the amount of noise in a day, I suspect the noise level would be similar or rather less because you've got electric machinery. I don't think it's to do so much with the height of the building, I think it's to do with the noise. And I think with electric machinery, lorries parked at New Haven, even though there's a 15% greater movement in a day than there is now, I think we might all be quite pleasantly surprised by the noise level. And for that reason, I appreciate what's been said regarding the height and so on, but for that reason overall, and it's a difficult call, I would approve the plans.
So
it's been very difficult to come to that decision.
So is that a proposal that you're saying?
Well, I'd like to hear what people say first.
Absolutely gone. Councillor Goodman.
Thank you, Chair. Yes, I could go along with Councillor Latham over there with regards to the electric noise level being down. Yes, I'm quite happy to second that. Thank you.
Councillor Moore?
Well, I'm not
going to
be voting, but I stand by what I said before.
Right, okay, you want a bit more information,
yes,
that's what you did like. Okay. Councillor Birch, would you like to say anything?
No.
Formally,
I've looked at the plans and all of them, and Mr. Green said he's going to put a screen of trees down there. Okay.
Yeah.
They're going to be a metre and a half or so back from the wall, so it doesn't damage the wall.
Right.
And that sort of thing. Be doing everything possible to keep the building to the standard it is now, in size it is now, but it can't quite make it, but the thing being is it is going quieter, and anything will be better than what's sitting there now.
Very quickly, I did actually spend quite a lot of time today at the size laser house looking over the wall. I also went in the graveyard.
Yep.
I actually walked around your yard as an artisan, and I've got to say, anything's got to look better than what you've got there at the moment, and can you, even if it's a bit higher.
Yeah,
I still think the
height is. Well, I do can't believe the building is going to be as high as this room, higher than what it is now.
Well, Lord, it's like a funny look, by the way.
Well, I'll just say it again that, you know, this height business, it either is that much higher or it's not.
Well,
we can't find out. Yeah, but it's too late to find out when it's up.
Right, so are you proposing, Councillor Latham, in the end, or?
Well, I
would. Oh, Councillor Argyle wants to support. Okay, so we've got
a
second Councillor Goodman. So we're not doing a call to vote today, so we're happy not doing a call. We didn't have a call.
Yeah.
So it's all those in favour.
Yeah.
One, two, three.
There is one proviso.
Go on.
That we find out the proper height.
No.
Well, we know it's.
We don't know.
There's
everybody with different views, different ideas of what the height is going to be. I want to know exactly from the whole now, the planners and how high it's going to be. Is it going to be 5 metres taller, or is it going to be no taller and the height's being taken out by their ground level?
I think we have to accept what's in their
statement.
And what I've been told personally by word of mouth from the person who drew the plans up.
You can't really get better than that. And I know there's been other conflicting statements, but I've been to the source, if you like, of the proper source of the information. And I've scoured the design and access statement to find out exactly, you know, whether it's in there first. And it is, and I read it to you, and it's admitted that it is going to be approximately 2.5 metres higher. And as I say, there's lots of mitigating factors, if you like, involved. You know, the fact it's going to be set in, the fact it's going to be purpose-built, all the things we've heard from Mr. Green to balance up against that, but it has to be accepted that it's going to be 2.5 metres higher than what's there, albeit, as I say, improved appearance and what's there, etc., etc., all the issues you've heard today. So, as I say, I think that has to be accepted. We can't put a proviso on there because it's quite clear what the facts are.
But a couple more caveats away from the
dog. I think we could put a caveat, subject to, probably doesn't go down too well with the Essex County Council, but we could draw their attention to the fact that the owners have said that they would fell Lylandii trees. And presumably that you can buy Lylandii trees that are 15, 20 foot high, fast growing. So that needs to be done very quickly, and the screening needs to be as comprehensive as possible to mitigate the effect on the local residents.
So obviously what you're trying to say, if approved, the conditions which I'm sure the county council will have, would you want the landscaping and screening to start as soon as possible?
Because we've been promised landscaping before by Sussex County Council, for example, down by the caravan park near Bishop's Stone Station, where the fence is there.
Right.
We were told, yes, there's going to be shrubs put along there, but in fact what we've got is a load of weeds, and the fence was done 2 years ago.
Well, in view of all the issues involved, in review of the length of debate, I was proposing to explain, if you've obviously supporting the application,
mm-hmm.
I will in a minute explain why you've supported it and the issues you've balanced off against each other, acknowledgement that the building is higher, and following what Councillor Layton just said, seek to, if it is granted consent, a priority should be placed on establishing screening as soon as possible, if that's your concern. But as I say, I think it's worthwhile making a few points as to why you are supporting the application in view of the views that have been made on both sides and obviously the importance of this of the application in the local area. So I will then sort of make a complete round off the resolution rather than just say resolution that be supported.
Councillor Goodman, you want to come back quickly?
No, I was going to say exactly the same as
All those in favour then?
It was four in favour.
Were you abstaining, Councillor?
Yeah.
Well, I have, because I know.
Yeah, you didn't like. Okay, I'm abstaining as well. I'm abstaining. I'm not voting either way.
It's carried four votes.
Four votes. Okay. I intend to have a short break at this stage, so don't let people who wish to leave the building at this stage before we start the rest of the application. Okay. Thanks very much for your time.
Thank you, Kelly.
Thank you
very much. Thank you.
Going down a metre and a half.
That takes off another.
You haven't really got far enough in, so it's probably fair to be out of the way.
That's what they're going to find.
It's going up more.
I wish I had driving off my road as well, all the rest of it. We don't help ourselves, that's what we can do. We hear those trains trying to get off, that doesn't help, that never happens.
I think it was a flaw in the figures. The height is not the relevant thing, it's the noise. The point you made is very important.
Yeah,
the lorry is being parked in New Haven, for example, because of the morning. You've got all the cab doors, you haven't got all the drivers passing around.
Well, I started with my mind.
That's a good bit.
Well, that's been recorded, isn't it?
We're not recording today, so we're all right.
I had a diesel van. You start much more, and you let them run to take
clutter away.
You've got those huge range lorries all banging away outside. Let me run them, that would be quite grateful, I would.
I'm sure they cut a few bits out.
It's not part of the meeting, though. It's a journey.
Right, sure, you just carry on then. Here we go, now.
Excuse me. You can go straight through.
I won't ask you every time, okay? That's fine. So, hopefully this next bit should be a bit more straightforward. Planning applications for weekending 27th of January 2017. LW 17-0027 6 Morris Road. Who would like to start on that one? Councillor Borman, you
a little bit of humour here, just to make sure that's not McCarthy and Stone. No, I fully support this application, Chair, and I hope that people who second my proposal will support it, Chair.
Okay, anyone else? Councillor Mason?
I second the proposal.
Okay, anyone else want to talk on it? Councillor Arjun?
Oh, I'll just
say. Oh, you're just seconding. Okay, right. So we're going to be supporting this application. So we've got Councillor Borman proposing, and Councillor has to get back into the. And Councillor Latham seconding. So all those in favour?
One, two, that's unanimous.
KLW 17-0050-18 Keydell Road. Who'd like to start? Councillor Goodman.
Thank you, Chair. Yes, I looked at the plans on this and I'm quite happy to support the application here presented.
Okay, and anyone else like Councillor Borman?
Yep, second Councillor Goodman proposal on that, Chair.
Okay. Anyone else make a comment, anything? Okay, so again, we've got Councillor Goodman proposing, Councillor Borman seconding, to all those in favour.
That's carried unanimously. Support application.
Okay, this. That's why I didn't bother. Is that the one? No. That's the one, isn't it?
Yes, no, that's the one.
That's the one, yeah, I thought it was that one. Yeah. Okay. LW 17-0046, One Bishop's Close. Now, this is getting interesting diagramming. I think everyone's on one bit of A4, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Councillor Latham.
I object to this application on the grounds that the application was appalling, and I can make head or tail of it. And I don't think we should approve the application presented in this way. We've made this point to Lewis several times before for such applications, and I think we've just got to say no, we can't comment on it. We would like to defer it and receive proper claims.
Okay, Councillor Goodman. Okay. So we've got so Councillor proposing and Councillor Goodman seconding really to propose and to wait. We defer this. I don't know if we've got time to do it in that meeting.
Well,
if we haven't, but
to make the point, yeah. I would suggest we can't support the application due to the difficulties in interpreting the plans and ask for, as I say, you can't really object because you don't really know what they're proposing. But what you can say is you can't support it because you don't know what they're proposing if you get them. So, could you?
Well, I object to it.
Called semantics, I suppose.
Yeah, we're just able to make an informed decision on the application.
Yeah, basically, that's basically what you're saying.
Yeah, so that's it.
I mean, it's almost as though like one of those sort of diagram books. I mean, you're trying to get everything on one bit of paper.
Due to difficulties in interpreting the plans, cannot make an informed decision,
and therefore,
unless
better and less clearer plans are received, you know, just have to submit no comment.
I hope Lewis would do the same.
Send
it back to the.
And then add what Councillor Lower suggested earlier to that generally, you know, the members are disappointed that applications like this are still being registered and validated when you know, there's no clear combined plans and members aren't able to compare existing with proposed.
I mean, my own opinion, again, I mean, we don't always mind if they are sort of, you know, they're not always as good as others, but if they could put it on about 3 pages, that might have made it a bit better, if they are going to do it like this.
But also the combined plans,
The general combined plans are a bit better for the download.
Yeah, so useful.
That's a very old-fashioned way of dealing with it. I mean, plans used to look like that 40 years ago. Making notes all over plans like that is very, you know, I've seen them before, but not for 30 years or so.
You say things like that, I just mind, you know, so that might be the best that they can afford for that. But is there, what I was going to ask, is there actually legislation on how they should present the plan? Because if Lewis has actually stamped that to accept it, then we're guessing that that's acceptable and perhaps it shouldn't be done then.
If they can afford a single store extension, they can afford
discretion involved.
It's being discretion.
I think we've voiced enough, I think, on this. So who was proposing again? Was it Councillor Latham and you were second Councillor? Right, so all those in favour on the referral subject to, to a few words there. Which
that was unanimous.
Yep, unanimous. Yeah. That's fantastic. Right, so LW17-0059, 27 Bishopstone Road, Bishopstone. So, it's along the long road going up to the village, isn't it, at the start, at the bottom. So, anyone want to start on that one? Anything of interest to note? Or a lot of them do have been along that road, don't they? Decking. That's important.
Yeah, so I think just to support the application.
Support. Seconded to Councillor Argent, so we've got a proposal and a seconder. Anyone else will talk on it? All those in favour to support?
That's unanimous.
Okay, LW17-0061, 4 Meads Road. And on the start, anything to add to talk about, Councillor Borman?
Yeah, just to support the application, Chair.
Councillor Goodman. Good. So we've got a proposal and a seconder. No one else wants to speak. All those in favour?
That's unanimous.
On that one. LW17-0062, the garage is down along Chichester Close. So, who would like to start this? Councillor Latham.
This is another example of SI Homes getting a court into the pint pot, I think. But basically, I've had a good look at this. I have no objection. I think they're far too small. There we are. So, no objection.
I can no objection to that, Councillor.
I'll second that as well, Councillor, as well.
We've got to propose a seconder. Anyone else want to talk about this? Or Councillor Borman?
So, if we just ask Councillor Latham, is it Sy Homes this one?
Yeah.
It is Sy Homes.
I'd have to say it.
Personal?
Yeah.
You know, but there's personal interest as opposed to. You can talk about it.
No benefit to me at all, but I'm just not keen on it.
Yes, I have Sy Homes.
That's fine.
So you won't vote, okay. Yeah, so we'll talk about.
No.
So we've got a proposal and seconder, so all those to support the application. Okay, one abstention. Okay. LW17-0070, 44 Kings Mead. Again, it's a side extension. Okay, on the Council Board members.
Yeah,
propose
that we accept this and support it.
Okay, second Councillor Goodman, right, so we've got proposed second. No one else wants to talk? No? All those in favour?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that's
good. Unanimous as well, that's good. Six Row Drive, that's LW17-0071. Who would like to catch the ball then?
Yeah, propose that we support this application.
Okay, we've got proposed second. No one else wants to talk, so all those in favour? That's unanimous again. Planning applications received weekending 10th of February 2017.
LW 1700067 Belgrave Road, two story extension for Mr. Usher. Who would like to speak to Councillor Lowe?
Yeah, I mean, this was another sort of amateur plan, but it was, well, you know, it was clearly drawn.
Yeah.
Not a lot of detail in it, but I couldn't see any objection to it.
Okay, you're proposing.
Yes.
Okay.
I'll second you.
Okay, so we'll propose a second. Anyone else will talk on it? No? Okay, so all those in favour to support?
Ms. Carroll, thank you. Unanimously.
Okay, LW 1700093 19 Pelham Road. Who would like to start? Councillor
Lowe. I'd like to support this application. There's already a precedent, number 22, and this is number 19. No objection.
Okay, you got no objection, Councillor Borman?
Yes, I'll second the Councillor's recommendation.
Okay, so we've got a proposal as a second. Anyone who works with a talk on it? No?
Mm-hmm.
So all those in favour?
That's apparently unanimous.
Okay, LW 1700094, this is Five Vale Road. Okay, so just a reminder, this has come back, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Council Board.
Yeah, that was in October 2015,
yeah.
Just to say.
Yeah.
Town Council raised no objection, Lewis Council refused it,
yeah.
And it's come back with far more supporting information and far stronger case, but basically it's the same development.
Sorry, yeah, interest in this possibility for what certain which the S stands for apparently, so I don't know what apparently is for it could be yeah.
So you might have a personal interest indirectly, so
yeah,
friend.
Yeah,
right.
Could be any S.
Right. Councillor Hill stop. Councillor Lowe or Councillor Latham? No, Councillor Latham, go on, you start.
Thank you. I object to this on the grounds that nothing really has changed since the previous submission, and it was out of character and in conflict with this District Council ST3 policy. I'm not quite sure what that is. Overbearing and spoiling the street scene was cited by this District Council, and it therefore looks like overdevelopment to me, and I think we should object to it.
Okay, Councillor Lowe, do you think it's changed at all?
No, I did vote against it the first time around, and I still think it's overdevelopment. It's
okay.
A busy corner, and it's just overdoing it. Second that. Not supported.
So that's going to be is that a proposal second, really?
Yeah.
Okay. Anyone else want to talk on it at all? Councillor Goodman?
Looking at the plans, actually, it does look rather cramped, to be honest. And I would go along with Councillor Latham and Councillor Love.
Okay. So really, I mean, if you do any objection again, are we going to say it's the same as last time? Is it really just, what did we do last time?
Well, no, we supported it last time,
but
obviously
because of
certain councils were against.
Yeah,
but I would say, yes, it's... So the members support the previous grounds for refusal on the previous application, that it's out of character, unacceptable impact on the locality, cramped development, and contrary to policy ST3, which is the residential amenity, safeguarding residential amenity type, general sort of fits all the policies on residential.
I thought there was some rather ambitious photography with the plans, in that the width of the hedge is essentially the width of the house, or perhaps twice.
It is very narrow.
And it's very, very narrow, and
yeah.
When you look at it full frontal, it looks as though the new house is the same width as the existing one. It can't possibly be. So I thought that was a good bit.
I mean, looking at the pictures, I've noticed that the hedges are sort of, obviously, they took summer pictures. So
yeah.
Look as though everything's in full bloom.
Yeah, yes.
Everything's in full.
Yes,
so in that sense, stuff is quite well hidden at the moment.
Yes.
But it's a tricky one. And it's slight, yeah, it's an interesting corner plot in a way on that road. But so we've
We've got a second. We've got a proposal mm-hmm. seconder for objection on
also
grounds of
corner very blind.
Jeffers.
If
going up,
yeah, yeah.
And you go up,
be
and the park cars at the back
yeah.
anyway.
Yeah.
So if we've got the objection on the table, we'll agree with those grounds already mentioned. So all those in favour to object.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in favour of objection.
And I'm going to abstain myself.
So as NEMCON objects,
yeah.
5 nil.
Okay.
2 abstentions.
Okay, LW 170101 4 Seagrove Way. Anyone like to talk about that?
Yeah, I would like to support the application as presented.
Okay, Councillor Borman?
Yeah, to second
that. Okay, anyone else?
No.
That's a lot of proposal and second there. All those in favour to support.
That's Councillor Anderson.
We've got a reconsultation on LW 161013, 31 Micklefield Way. So they obviously changed their ideas from becoming a first floor to a single storey front and rear instead. Councillor Latham.
Thank you, Chair. And I'd like to support the application. I think they've taken on board the objection very well. And no objection to proceeding.
Councillor
Borman?
Yeah,
we are
seconding Councillor Latham.
Okay. Anyone else want to talk on it? So we've got a proposal seconder, so all those in favour to support the amendment. There was that one below. 1-3 works application, TW 170018/TCA, 36 Blackington Hill. Captain Borman?
Yeah, the Oliver Corchalis, which is what we worked for this evening, supports this application. I think we should support any recommendation we have.
Right, so you're proposing, so anyone want to second? Councillor Goodman, thank you. We've got a proposal in the second. Anyone else want to make any comments? Councillor Lowe?
I agree, but I think it's really annoying that they don't put in the application how tall they are now. I mean, we've got them and look, but why should we?
That's a very good point.
Yeah.
That's
what I mean.
That's a very, very good point.
But anyway, so we've got a proposal in second. That's all those in favour to do the works. That's unanimous. Okay, agenda item 5, consultation responses on planning applications.
So this is guidance that's been brought to our attention by Lewis District Council. Their policy when considering comments from parish and town councils is to, where there's no objection, which is obviously a common resolution in the past from this council, they treat it as a neutral standpoint. As I say, I don't necessarily agree with that, because the whole idea of the planning system is that when you put an application in, you're entitled to consider that application should be approved unless there's a good reason why it should be refused. So that there's no real neutral standpoint unless you don't want to make any comments at all for any reason. So I would regard no objection as akin to support. But it's obvious that Lewis District Council want a clearer indication from us as a town council. So obviously I will suggest that whereas in the past, when we've seen no reason to object to an application, we've said no objection, we now state our positive support for the application and say where it's appropriate. Also, the district council would want us in more significant applications. I mean, most of our applications are house extensions. They wouldn't really expect us to give proper reasons, but in a more complex application like the Cradle Hill Industrial Estate one, for example, we would be expected to give a summary of our reasons for supporting, and where appropriate, the policies which we consider are relevant, and whether those policies are, whether we consider the proposal to be contrary or supported by the relevant policies. without obviously going into too much technical detail. So it's a reasonable request, as I say, and don't necessarily agree with it 100%, but it's something which I think I would recommend that we adopt and start to express our support rather than simply no objection.
Do we say support as we have been trying to tonight, or approved? It's not for us to approve, so presumably we say support.
We say support.
Support
the application. Yeah, that's they want that to be the standard, standard expression. I mean, many loads of town councils all over the country still have a standard no objection resolution.
Mm-hmm.
Seems to be good enough for authorities all over the country, but. As I say, it's a slightly odd request, a slightly odd bit of guidance, but it's no great burden to go along with it.
No,
it's
no problem.
God, Councillor Borland on this.
Just be nice that Lewis District Council listens to our recommendations.
Well, it does ensure that we. Yes, it does ensure that we listen to the
board. Well, Councillor Borland.
Thank you, Chair. Going on to the next one, number six, I've noticed
thank
that
you.
They're saying that
we have
no objection. And they're saying no objection from the STC.
Oh. Yes, that's me. I'll have to amend that to support.
Right, so we're going to note.
Sorry,
Jeff. We're going to note item five. Any else? Yeah, we're supporting. I mean, if it is an objection, we really just say objection. We don't need any fancy
yes,
word
yes,
for that.
Either you either object
or
you
support.
Support.
There's nothing else in
there.
They
want something positive to keep them happy.
Yep, so that's fine. So we've got a proposal. We'll second that. So we're all those in favour to know.
Right, thank you.
Right, and finally, item number six. Item six, the report, the update report. Just a note. Anything to say?
No report.
That's noted.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, with the item five, I would say the resolution is to adopt or follow the guidance from Lewis District Council.
Yeah, absolutely. Right, so I thereby declare the meeting is closed.
8:12.
8:12. 8:12.